It's the Akron Tannehate Eternal, and you're getting your fix of metal injection.
Rob here with all-around metal guy, Eric Rutan. Guys just destroyed New England Metal Fest. Everyone might as well just go home after you guys play it. I mean, what's the point?
Nice compliment. I appreciate it.
And I mean, you're a very busy guy because not only are you tearing it up with Hate Eternal, you produced some of the most brutal records of the year.
Thanks.
Is it hard being Eric Rutan?
It can be at times. when it comes to scheduling, it's very hard because I always feel like I'm not doing enough, even though, like somebody said to me the other day, like, goddamn, every record I bought had your name on it some way, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess I keep busy, but, you know, when you love what you do, like I do, I love producing bands, I love playing music, so, you know, it is tough in some ways, but man, you know, nothing to go wah-wah about. I mean, you know, I got two careers in metal. I mean, you know, I love producing music and I love playing it, and you know, I never take it for granted, man. You know, I get to work with killer bands and I get to, you know, play in a band that I've worked on for a long time.
You have been known to be a bit of a perfectionist. I've heard that word sprung with your name, and how do you and like when you're either producing a record or recording a record, when do you pull away from you're like, all right, I think I'm done with this, you know, like I have to step away.
Actually, when the deadline is, you know, when someone from the label calls and said, hey, where the hell is my record? Oh, shit, I better get it done. You know,
Have you ever been like, just like two more days of mixing?
You know, it's hard to let go of the records because, you know, I care about everyone. I want it to be, you know, perfect, and it never is, you know, nothing's perfect, but you know, sometimes, a few times I've had it where I'm like, you know what? It's done. Ready to rock. Let's get it mastered. But a lot of times, you know, I'm just working as much as I can. You know, I've put everything I have. When I'm producing somebody, my whole life is that record, you know, and I always look at it for what it is. A record's forever.
Right.
And forever I'm going to be associated with it. So I really want to give everything I have to it. So, and the band, every band deserves that, you know.
With this new record, Fury in the Flames, do you listen to it now that it's done, it's out? Are you like, man, I wish if I had like another day, I would just change this part?
Yeah, totally. It's hard. It's hard because I try to give myself time after every record. Once it's mastered and I proofed it and all that, I don't listen to it for months because I can't even listen to it, you know, without having some form of opinion on something and like, oh, I should have brought this up and I should have tweaked this.
In terms of producing, like, how does that work? Does a band ask you, and like, do you pick who you want to produce?
Well, most of the times it's been bands like contacting me or labels saying, or managers sometimes, you know, hey, we want you to produce this band. And then sometimes I've actively gone out to produce some bands. Like, oh man, that band's awesome. I'd love to produce them.
Have you ever like turned stuff down? Like, that's too pussy for Eric Rutan.
It maybe be more like, man, my schedule's booked.
Right.
You know, rather than, you know, I love all music. So if it's good music, it's good music. If I see a potential nightmare, then maybe I'll be like, eh, you know. But if it's a good band, then I welcome it. But, you know, it's all subjective to what is good and what's not. But, I mean, good music's good music, regardless of the style or genre. I mean, I grew up listening to everything, metal, hardcore, you know, classical music, rock, you know, you name it. Yeah. So
I was interviewing Through the Eyes of the Dead when their record came out, and they were saying how while you were in the studio, you just kept talking about the Evanescence record, and you're like, man, it was so well produced that it's like...
It is an amazing sounding record. Dave Fortman, I mean, he's a guy that I just, something about him I look up to because he was a guy, he was like, you know, he did Super Joint Ritual and he did Soul and Green before I started producing him. And then he gets a call one day and it's like, hey, yeah, we, you know, I've heard the story from the Soylent guys. You know, he gets this call. We got the band, you know, with girl singer. We need somebody to produce. Are you interested? Ah, yeah, I'm free. You know, not knowing that a couple years later, it's going to be a couple Grammys and 12 million albums sold. You know what I mean? So I just, something about that, I think it's just amazing to think, like, you know, you're always one record away from just making the big one. You know, right, so right. I really respect that, you know.
If Evanescence gave you the call, would you be like, I'd love to produce a record?
Sure. Yeah.
You don't turn it down.
You'd like to broaden your horizons, right?
Totally, yeah.
Usually metal fans, they're just like closed into one sub-genre of metal, and they don't expect anyone to listen to anything else. But it's good to see that, you know, someone as brutal as Eric Rutan just has a...
I love death metal, of course. You know,
I mean, obviously.
I play extreme death metal, you know,
but... you can't just listen to death metal.
No. I mean, I grew up listening to all kinds of stuff, you know. Before death metal, I was listening to Iron Maiden and, you know, and things of that. But I think to be a true musician is to appreciate all forms of music in some capacity, you know, so...
Absolutely, yeah.
I mean, there's some music I don't enjoy listening to, but I can say, oh, geez, you know, that guy is awesome or whatever. I just appreciate good music, period, regardless of the style or the genre.
Now you guys play the New England Metal Fest. Were there any bands that you tried to check out here tonight that you normally wouldn't be able to see?
Behemoth, you know, which I was able to get a quick glimpse only because I'm doing interviews, but Behemoth is awesome, and I saw some Vital Remains. I didn't get to see Through the Eyes there, which I really is disappointing because I wanted to because I was doing interviews, but it's tough, you know. Today is like, I've been doing interviews since 1 o'clock, so I haven't had a chance except for to play, so, but try to get a little clips of the bands I want to. I'd like to see a little bit of Dimmy Borgir, so.
Well, we won't keep you too much longer.
Nah, no problem, man.
Well, let's just talk about Fury of the Flames a little. Obviously, there was a bit of a rough patch of time before it. Was it a little hard getting back in the flow of, like, making a record after going through what you did?
Oh, totally, yeah. I mean, you know, the lineup change was, like, only a small portion. It was really Jared's, my old bass player that passed away, that really affected me, and... had some other tragic deaths in my family, you know, that happened all within a time frame. So I really had to regroup and look for support from my family, friends, and stuff to keep everything in perspective. But I mean, to me, music's always been that outlet, that expression of all that. And Fury and Flames, there's no better example of like the outlet of all that emotion going on because I was producing, you know, 6 Feet Under, Vital Remains, and Through the Eyes. I was doing all these records, so I didn't really have a chance to do what you got to do to take care of yourself, you know, in that way, you know, grieving and things of that nature. So I was just writing music, and the record became about so much more than just doing an album. It was like in honor of one of my best friends and my old bandmate, and I wanted to make a big impact with that. And so it became so much more integral and a huge part of my life. So when it was actually done, I was in a state of depression for a while just because I've been building and building for this album, and then it was finally done. It was like, wow, you know, like then I had to get back to just dealing with what I needed to, you know, type of situation. But it was therapeutic for sure, you know, to do this record, and glad that it came out the way it did and people have seen it at face value. The self-will, you know, if you can reach deep inside, you know, I've had to many times in my life to, you know, battle adversity and things of that nature. So, you know, if that's why I always say to anybody, man, you can achieve anything you put your mind to, you know, if you just focus on it.
Yeah, absolutely. And
would you say it's harder to, like, work on your own music since it's, like, you are your only judge than, like, helping another band, like producing another band's music? Do you think it's a little more difficult working on your own stuff?
Much harder.
Yeah.
I mean, it's easier in the sense of like working with your old band, you know everybody personality-wise. You know, it's a different relationship. Some bands, you're just getting to know them, and you know, I've got a pretty strong personality, so I'm kind of a no-nonsense, to-the-point guy. You know, I don't mess around. I don't placate. I just like to get to the point. Not that I'm I can be a dick, but, you know, I mean, everybody can. But, you know, it's not enough time to mess around the studio. You got to be straightforward. Hey, this guy, do it again. Tighten this up. But doing your own record is it's one of those evil love-hate relationships. Like, every record I say, you know what? I'm not going to mix the next one, and then I still do, so obviously I must enjoy it, but it's really hard, especially mixing it, you know, because you're working, producing it, all that stuff's smooth, getting the tones, you know, I do it all day long. It's when you get to mixing, and I did all the vocals and the guitars, and by that point, you're already burned down a little bit, you know, and you care about it so much, so it's really, can be difficult for sure.
In spite of all that, I think you made an amazing record. You guys are awesome. And thank you for taking the time to do this.
Thanks a lot.
It was awesome. And check out some Hate Eternal right now on Metal Injection.